In this section, we're going to talk about some of the subtle features of ACE that don't really present themselves in all situations, and we're going to refer to this section as advanced features. Whenever you're in the Add Edit Context dialog menu, you may have noticed a latency section at the bottom. It's expressed in number of seconds. And this latency is only used if you have two conditions. You have a naturally scheduled calculation, and there are multiple input tags. And when there are multiple input tags, the system has to make certain decisions about when to do the calculation based on which tag's firing. And this is referred, this period is referred to as the latency period. And we've got a couple illustrations here examining some of the common cases. Let's say we have tag A and tag B, and the tag A and tag B can trigger the ACE calculation where, again, we're naturally scheduled. And we get a value for tag A into the system, into the snapshot subsystem. We will wait the latency period, as illustrated by this double-headed arrow, until the end of the latency period to actually do the calculation. The calculation will be time-stamped with the triggering event, but it will be performed after the latency period. The reason we do this is because we want to wait and see if there are any other tags that come in. If we get a second trigger before the latency period ends, we will immediately force the calculation based on the initial trigger, and then we will begin the latency period all over again for the second trigger event. After that latency period ends, we will perform a second calculation. Again, time-stamped with the timestamp of the trigger. If we have two trigger tags, tag A and tag B, and tag A comes in and triggers the calculation, and for some reason we get a tag B triggering before the tag A trigger as far as timestamps, we will perform a calculation based on trigger B, and then tag A will continue to wait the latency period. So these are just some of the permutations, and this illustrates why in a naturally scheduled tag, you don't see the calculations right at the trigger event. Even though they're timestamped that way, you don't see them until after the latency period ends. The way ACE works by default is that it reads all the snapshot values of any input tags at trigger time, and it uses these values during the processing. If there are any archive values required, say you use a tag average or other function where it gets a range of values, the ACE calculation will go into the archive and retrieve any values it needs during this processing. And so by default, ACE will gather snapshots, gather archive values, and perform any calculations. It will write the value or the result of your calculation at the end of the calculations. However, it will be timestamped with the trigger time. So you will get the correct timestamp. It just may not appear for a few seconds or moments until the calculation has been run. And ACE does not write any intermediate results that it calculates. If you do want to write any interim results for calculations that have a lot of iterations, you can use the tag name put value function. This will force writing a value during any iteration of the calculation. So you can write intermediate results, or you can another side effect of using this function is that it will force writing values even during testing and debugging. So you can use the put value function to use for that. If you have certain constructions like if then statements with no else, you may get a result for an output tag that says calc failed if it doesn't arrive at a correct result for one of the output tags. Let's say you have a if something occurs, then write this value to this tag. If not, write this value to another tag. And there is no evaluation. The statements don't meet the evaluation criteria. You don't necessarily want to write calc failed to those tags. So to avoid sending data to Pi in those situations, you can use tag name send to Pi equals false. And that is handy in case you have a situation where you don't necessarily want to write a value for every one of your output tags in all instances. ACE will normally use API calls to send data to the Pi server as exception data. It's the same process that interfaces use. If for some reason you want to force data written to the Pi archive for a specific timestamp and you want it to overwrite anything that's in there at that point, you can use the tag name arc mode equals DM replace duplicates function in order to force that behavior. There are two areas in the code in the ACE wizard that aren't used as often as others, and the first one is the user variable declaration section. If you have variables that you do not want reinitialized from calculation to calculation, you can declare them in this area, and these values will be carried on or perpetuated between successive calculations. They're only reset when the context is taken out of service. You also have the UserDefined Termination and Initialization sections, and these sections are used for various functions, sometimes to release objects and variables, and sometimes they're used to write special instructions when the calculation is initialized or terminated. And we're going to see an example of that in a moment. You can use data from outside sources in ACE. You're not limited to just Pi data. That's one of the powerful features of ACE. You just simply have to use some sort of communication protocol like OLEDB, ODBC, or ADO to retrieve data from a foreign system. And you can store the rules or queries for the retrieval in the module database. If you're using any external functions, you simply have to add those as references to your project. You can build your own libraries. And please make sure that if you are developing on multiple machines, that the required libraries are installed and migrated if you're moving your ACE executable from one machine to another. And this is simply a screenshot of adding a reference to an ACE or Visual Basic project.